still relatively fresh. Go the fuck on, dickhead. Anyhow, so I'm on my way from TSB's Rebel Podcast 2022 workshop down in Dallas-Fort Worth area of Texas. And that was kind of a miniature adventure for me. I'd never been west of the Mississippi, and I had sort of a last-minute opportunity to go down there and help out as one of the staff members. And I jumped at the opportunity, and I emailed Jack, and it all worked out, and so down I went. Nothing's kind of squared away at the homestead, so it wouldn't be hopefully a huge pain in the butt for my wife to take care of. And I hit the road, and by the way, that's 14 hours from Knoxville. Heading back to stop in the Hog and I catch a respite there before I continue on in the early morning. But, you know, it's really hard to summarize what these kind of workshops are like. I've attended, you know, the ones we told us at the Living Free in Tennessee podcast, and they're fantastic, and Jack's are as good. In fact, hers are, you know, kind of modeled off of the way Jack puts things together, so. Similar topics, similar setup in a lot of ways. They bring in all kinds of talent, all kinds of knowledgeable people on a variety of topics, not just about the Sinopolis, like you said, but a lot of mindset work, a lot of business building, creative side hustles. And the biggest and best part of this is the people. And over the last few years, I've been able to, you know, gradually just add more and more quality individuals to my circle. People who know things, people who are willing to share knowledge, people who exercise critical thinking. I'm a real big fan of that. Folks who are compassionate, yet they don't let people walk all over them. They've got a backbone. It's also important to me. So many other traits. I can't even really list them all off right now. But, you know, we go for the people. That's really what it boils down to. And yes, there's class time and there's teaching and there's demos and all that kind of stuff. And good God, do we eat a lot of really good food. But really, mostly, it's about the interaction, and they structure the workshop so that there's plenty of time, both during the day and in the evening and the after hours, for all the networking, all the wheeling and dealing to go on. It's just a phenomenal, phenomenal experience. And I just, you know, wanted to pass along that if these are things that you're interested in, if you are somebody who's a doer, who wants to improve things about their life, about their, you know, their own personal journey, then these kind of workshops are the ones to look for. So this goes for Self-Reliance Fest, this goes for Cole's workshops, it goes for Jack's workshops. It goes for all the events being put together by other people within these networks, because it's just blossoming out as everybody kind of finds their little niche and starts going after it. It's just such quality time. So, I don't think I have a whole lot more specific to add right now, except just to say, you know, keep your eye on it. Jack always does his the second week in November. Nicole's is usually in April. Things don't go sideways with the outside world. And if you're the kind of person that you are ready to make changes in your life, you're ready to go after something, this is a group of people. Everybody's going to encourage you to do it. Everybody is going to help you troubleshoot and find creative workarounds. It really doesn't matter what it is. Somebody is going to be there who has a clue. Because it brings in people from all sectors. We've got tech guys and farmers and rednecks and all of the skills, all the trades, all the knowledge. Financial people, just insurance people. It really is in this handyman. I don't feel like we have a gap anywhere. And in some ways, like I kind of feel protective of it because it's so damn genuine. I don't want any of these to get too big. And I don't think organizers like Jack and Nicole want to make them too big, because then they can't, then they know something is lost. So what we can do is, when we get together, we, you know, we decide to form our own events. It doesn't have to be for 4 days. You know, I'm going to be doing one. It's just going to be 1 day. But we'll do it quarterly. And that way, you know, as we kind of all return to our various, you know, corners of the country, we can keep this ball rolling and keep, you know, finding the others. So that's what I got. Watching kind of a really cool sunset in my rearview mirror, and it's going to be dark soon, and I won't be too far from the holler to catch my rest, which would be great. Nicole's always super kind and accommodating. So, y'all take it easy.